ChatGPT, create a list of 10 single words for a word search book related to the 1950s.
Wow, this thing is absolutely amazing. Now, if you're struggling to come up with the content for the interiors of your KDP low content and medium content books to self-publish on Amazon, then what I'm about to show you will absolutely blow your mind. So we're just going to go straight into it. Now, over the last 12 months, there has been a proliferation of various artificial intelligence or AI tools, and you've probably seen the results of these on platforms like YouTube or Instagram with these amazing images that have been created. Well, recently, there's been a new tool that's come out called ChatGPT from this company called OpenAI. And at the time of publishing this video, it's absolutely free. And so I started to have a play around with it. And in fact, one of the first questions I asked it was this: what low content journals could I make with ChatGPT? And you can see some of these suggestions are actually quite good. So I thought, okay, take it a step further and asked it, what types of puzzle books could I make using ChatGPT? And again, amazingly enough, it came out with these suggestions, some of which I think are actually really good suggestions. So I investigated this further, experimented, and came up with 7 low content or medium content book niches where I think this tool would be great for creating the content for. So, first of all, we've got the word search puzzle book niche. So I went ahead and asked it this question: create a list of 10 single words for a word search book related to cats. Look at how quick that is. Now, I've only done 10 words here, but you could do this for any number of words you need to fill your book, and you could do it in any niche you want. You see, the problem with a word search puzzle books is actually coming up with lists of ideas for words to use. And it previously involved, you know, doing searches on Google or even buying books off Amazon of lists of words. But one of the beauties of this is that you could actually create lists of words for really obscure niches. So you could create word search books, not for those common niches, but for those quite unusual niches where you would ordinarily have difficulty coming up with lists of words. The second niche idea was around crossword puzzles. Again, the difficulty in creating these types of books is coming up with ideas for the questions and the answers. So over to ChatGPT, create 10 crossword puzzle clues and answers related to, let's say, dogs. It's coming up with these questions and answers. And again, I've just limited it to 10 questions. You could do this for any number of questions you wanted and also for any niche you wanted. And the third niche idea was one suggested by ChatGPT, and that is for prompt journals. So I went ahead, create 10 prompts for a prompt journal. And again, it comes up with suggestions really quickly. Again, I limited it to 10. You could do this for any number of pages you want, probably 365 if you wanted to do a prompt journal for a whole year. And I even tried create 10 drawing prompts for a journal. And again, it comes up with these really good ideas. Now, the fourth niche idea, again, which was suggested by ChatGPT, was a gratitude journal. So create 10 prompts for a gratitude journal. And there we go. It's so easy. You don't have to spend ages racking your brain trying to come up with ideas for all different types of prompts for these types of journals. Idea number 5, we go back to the puzzle book niche. And I came up with this idea for word scrambles. So ChatGPT, create 5 word scrambles with answers. Boom, there we go, as quick as that. Sixth niche idea was anagrams. So again, create 5 anagrams. This is so easy. And so you could use these, not just in one book about anagrams, which you could do, but you could add these into activity books, puzzle books, where you have lots of different types of puzzles or activities. So this really is a shortcut for creating content for these types of books. Now, the 7th niche idea or area was around quizzes. And that was coming up with questions and answers that you could use in maybe a book full of quiz questions, or again, as part of a puzzle book or activity book. So I went ahead and asked GPT, create 5 football trivia questions. And again, it comes up with the questions and also the answers. Now, I know nothing about American football, so you would have to go and check the answers on Google by doing a simple search. But you could use this to create quizzes, questions in all different types of niches. Here's another one I tried. Create 2 quiz questions related to dogs with 4 multiple choice answers for each. And again, it does exactly as I ask. Now, here's a bonus suggestion, and that's obtaining quotes. Now, normally you have to go through Google or lists of quotes in a book, or go through a book picking out quotes. Or watch this. Create the top 10 quotes from Marcus Aurelius. And look at how quickly we get this information. And this is a game changer. This could save so much time if you're looking for this type of information. Now, I know some of you are going to say, oh, this is going to ruin the low content book market. It's going to be even easier to create these types of books. It's going to saturate the market even more. It's all over. It's come to an end. Well, like it or not, this technology is here to stay. So you either embrace it and use it, or ignore it and just go about looking for a different type of business to do online. Now, I've only probably touched on the periphery of the type of things you could do with this technology. So if you do come up with any ideas, suggestions of how we could use these for creating low content, medium content books, then please let me know in the description below. I find this area so exciting. Now, if I have piqued your interest into creating these types of books to publish on Amazon, then I suggest watching this playlist next. It's my book tutorials playlist, where I go through all the steps of creating and publishing low content books on Amazon. Thank you very much for your time. It is very much appreciated. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button. And until next time, goodbye.